Hi, my name's Rob Gillum. I'm owner-operator of Weller Bee Supply, and I'm also the leader of the Black Fork Bee Club. I'm in Mansfield, Ohio. We've been in bees now for about 35 years, so I had a few people ask me what some of the steps are in order to prepare for winter, so I wanted to go over just a few things. We talked about honey-bound hives and what you should do about that in one of the previous videos. So we're going to move on to what we actually do to prepare if our hives are light. And what I mean by light is, do they have enough stores in order to get them through the winter? So there's a whole lot of things in which you need to do or what you want to check before you go into winter. And one of them is your varroa count. Varroa mites are still the number one killer of our bees. If they go into the winter with a varroa mite problem, they'll most likely not make it till spring. So one of the things that you're going to want to do is check varroa counts, treat however you feel best for you. I use the oxalic acid vaporizers, and I've had really good luck with them. They claim that they have 100% kill if they're done properly. So that's another thing that you need to look into. What shape is your hive in health-wise before you even go into looking at, you know, do they have enough stores to get them through the winter? So one of the things I brought with me here is this is a top hive feeder. It's a floating rack. It has racks in it that will float. When you pour your sugar water in, they'll actually float, and that gives the bees something to get off on. I have very minimal drowning with this. They've worked really well for me. I also use them for another purpose, and I'll show you that later in the video. During the fall, if your hive is low on food, you'll want to feed them a 2-to-1 sugar water. 2-to-1 would be, I've mixed by the gallon, so if you have a gallon of water which weighs roughly 8 pounds, you would be using 16 pounds of sugar. So that's how you get your 2-to-1 ratio. So what I'm going to do here is, this is, like I say, this is a feeder that I use to not only feed my hives in the spring and fall, but I also use this feeder in the winter, and I'll show you later on what we do. This is a candy board. There again, I use this on all of my hives. I don't care whether they're heavy or light. All my hives get a candy board. This is just insurance to me that if they run low on stores, they have 16 pounds of sugar that will hopefully get them through to spring. If they don't use it, then I can convert it to sugar water in the spring. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you here how I mix this. Like I say, I'm going to use 16 pounds of sugar in the candy board. So I've got 16 pounds of sugar here, but I'm only going to mix 8 pounds at a time, because it gets a little tough stirring if you try stirring all 16 pounds at once. So the sugar now seems like it comes in 4-pound bags, so it makes it a little easier for the math. Also, when you're mixing your syrup, if you're doing 1-to-1, you use 8 pounds of sugar to 8 pounds of water, which is 1 gallon. So I'm gonna put 8 pounds of sugar in this bowl. And I've already got my water measured out here. Use 3 cups of water, and I won't pour it in all at once. Better set this back here. My table's pretty unlevel. And I use white vinegar. Now, don't take much of the white vinegar, because all this is doing is just kind of trying to prevent a little bit of mold. But I'll use one tablespoon of white vinegar to my 3 cups of water. Mix that up a little bit. And what I'm going to do now is I'll just pour half of my water into the 8 pounds of sugar. And we're going to pour about half of our water in here, roughly about a cup and a half. So we're pretty close there. Now, what this does is when you mix it, it'll just clump up. It's not really wet. It just kind of helps the sugar to hold shape while you're putting it in your candy board. So I'm going to mix this around, get it worked into the sugar good. I want this to be kind of moist. I want all of it to be moist, and you'll see why. I'll pack this into my candy board, and this way it just helps it hold shape better. Okay, that seems to be pretty good there. Now, what I'll do, once you get this mixed up, it seems like it's clumping well. I want it to hold. When I pack it, I want it to be able to hold that shape. That way I know I've got most of the moisture or water mixed into the sugar. Okay, and what I'm going to do here, I have another hive top here that I'm going to place over here on top of the hive. You can use, I mean, if you have a table, just put you a sheet of plastic, a trash bag, anything that you have that will kind of repel the water in case you're working on a wood table or something so you don't damage it. But I would put newspaper down. Newspaper, or I would even use my paper that I get off of my foundation to put in here first to help hold the sugar. And I don't do that anymore because if the bees don't use the sugar through the winter, I can use this sugar in the spring in order to make sugar water. Well, if you put newspaper down there, it's just a real job to get the paper off of the sugar. It makes a mess when you're trying to mix it. So I don't use the newspaper anymore. And I just put my sugar directly into the candy board. Now I'm going to show you the candy board here. We have a front entrance here. This not only helps with ventilation, this gives your bees a place to come and go in the winter without having to go through the bottom entrance. Being in the winter time, most of your bees are up at the top of the hive. They're going to be close to this anyway, so this just makes easy access for the bees to come and go. Now, if you don't get out on a regular basis and check your entrances, which you should, because you don't want snow to build up on your entrances and you want to keep that ventilation coming through your hive. Now this hive here, this is just a hive I've got set up, a mock hive. This has a ventilated bottom board, but in the winter time, I personally keep my my bottom closed up. The only ventilation I need is what's coming through my entrance. So now I've got half inch hardware cloth in the bottom. I like the half inch hardware cloth. I've used quarter inch before, but it seems like the bees have a little bit of a rough time getting through it. So I went to the half inch, and I like it. It seems to work well for me. So what I'm going to do is I'll place this on top of this hive top I have here. And I use this block of wood. Now what this block of wood's going to be for is I'll place that in front of the hole, their entrance hole. And I can take the sugar then, pretty much just dump it in. Okay, just pour it right into your candy board. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and kind of pack it in. Hold your mold in place. And I'm going to just pack it around that. I'm going to bring the sugar up and pack it in. And it don't have to be anything pretty, but it just kind of pack it down. Keep your board in place. You can kind of level it out, keep it even. But once I've packed it in here, I can take and remove this block, and that keeps a space for the bees to be able to come up through the hive and to be able to exit, enter and exit the hive. We'll go ahead and mix up the rest of our sugar. Now you'll see on the internet all kinds of configurations for sugar boards, candy boards. There's all kinds of different ideas. I'm not saying that one's better than the other, but I've used this and I've had good luck with it. It's something that, like I say, if the bees need it, that's great that it's there. If they don't need it, that's fine also. 4 bags of sugar will run me about $8. It costs about $2 a bag. The way I look at it is that's pretty cheap insurance to get you through the winter if it needs to. Usually if we have a January thaw or we get a day that's warm, sun's out, I'll open the hives up just long enough to take a look at the candy board to see if they've started on it. And like I say, it's just kind of a insurance policy for me, because I just feel that it's a whole lot easier to put it on in the beginning of the winter than it is to worry about whether you need to get in your hive and add something in January, February. Okay, we've got this mixed up pretty good. It's damp, it's holding shape good. I'm going to bring us back over here. Now what I'm going to do now is I'll take this block and I put it in the back corner. And the reason I do that is this is going to act as a ventilation or a hole in order for the air to still be able to come up through the hive. Just helps with the ventilation. Same way, I'm going to pack this around the piece of wood, my form. Just pack it in good. I can take this block then, bring it over to the other side and do the same thing. And all that does is that just gives you a little bit more ventilation coming up through the hive. I can't overemphasize, you need ventilation in your hive in the winter months to get rid of moisture. Moisture is the bees' biggest enemy in the winter months. If you don't get rid of the moisture, you'll end up with dead bees. As the bees consume honey, they're actually expelling moisture. So as they're eating their stores, they're putting off more and more moisture into the hive. And when you have the heat from the bees and the cold temperatures outside, you're creating moisture condensation. So you gotta be able to expel that from the hive. So I've got this packed in here pretty good. Try to just keep it level so that my lid and my other feeder will go on top of this. So I've got it packed in pretty good. Now by tomorrow, this sugar will be like a rock. It'll get really hard. So it shouldn't go anywhere when I go to put it on the hive. That should do there. Again, I can remove my form. Take a look at it here. I've got ventilation in my back corners and I have my access for the bees. This also gives access to the bees. So this here, that's all there is to creating or setting up your candy board. Now, what I do then, set this off to the side here, this out of the way. Okay, so now we're ready to put our candy boards on. The season is over. Our temperatures have got cooler. The bees aren't bringing in anything anymore. So now's when I'm going to put my candy board on. So I've opened my hive up. I can remove my inner cover, maybe. There again, I've got 10 frame hive. Now what I do is I've got these little strips of wood. They're a quarter inch thick, and I place them over top of the frames. I just kind of spread them out evenly. And what that does is when I set the candy board on, the screen isn't really strong enough to support the weight of the sugar, but the strips will. So when I place this on here, the strips will push the candy back up where it belongs, and that maintains your bee space. It gives your bees room to move around inside the hive. Your sugar or candy board hasn't went down against your frames and limited their moving inside the hive. So I've got my candy board on. So now I'd talk to you about the feeder that I use. And what I'm going to do now is feeding's over. I fed all I can feed. I'm hoping they've put enough away that it get them through the winter. So now my feeder is going to become an insulator. Not only will the sugar absorb moisture, when I put my feeder on top here, what I'm going to do, there again, my feeder's got two compartments here for the sugar water. It's got your access slot here for the bees. Well, I'm going to place that right on top of my candy board. And then I've got plenty of pine shavings. Now you can go to any farm store and pick up pine shavings. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill these compartments with pine shavings. Okay? I'm going to just fill them right up. If you get a little bit down on the sugar, it isn't going to hurt anything. You can place your board across there, or cardboard or something if you're worried about it. But you can fill your compartments here with sawdust. Okay, so I've got them pretty well filled. Now what this is going to do is this is not only going to act as a moisture absorbent, it's also going to give your hive a little bit of insulation on top of the hive. They say if you can raise the temperature of the top of your hive just by a couple degrees, condensation won't form above your bees and drip down on them. So this is not only going to act as moisture absorbent, it's also going to act as an insulator. So once I've filled those, one of the other things that I do to my hive, and I do this, and I run the same thing year round. This is called coroplast. This is made from political signs. You can get it, a lot of your political signs are made from coroplast, and what it is, it's like a plastic cardboard. So I use this for different things. You can use it for small hive beetle traps, and there's different things that you can use it for, but it's handy. But what I'll do is I'll take and cut four pieces about 2 inch square, and I will place these on the inside corners of my outer cover. And these work good in the summer months too. Let's see where I put my staple gun. All right, we found our staple gun. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take and put a staple in each one of these core plastic squares that I put in my outer cover, just to hold them in place. That way they're not moving around. But what that does is these are just maybe a little over an eighth inch thick. So generally you don't have too much trouble with unwanted bees and stuff coming in through the summer months and the fall, especially when robbing's so bad. But what this allows is it allows air to pass around through your outer cover in between each one of the core plastic squares. So now I'm going to place this on top of my hive. I've allowed ventilation to come up through my hive. So as long as you have air moving through it, you shouldn't have any trouble with moisture. Now this time of year, I've removed my hive reducer, my entrance reducer, because there again, the threat of robbing and, you know, unwanted bees has passed, so I don't have to worry so much about the robbing and your wax moths and so forth. So now, this time of year, I'm putting my mouse guard on. So my mouse guard will not only act as what it should do, it's still going to allow ventilation to come up through my hive. So I can't overemphasize, if you live in an area where you get a lot of snow, keep your entrances clean. Allow that air to come up through your hive. So that's all I have. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'm part of the Black Fork Bee Club. You can go to blackforkbeeclub.com, wellerbeesupply.com. We also have Weller Bee Supply and Black Fork Bee Club on Facebook. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe. And we hope to do more, and we'll keep bringing more and more videos to you as we can. So thank you. And happy beekeeping.